हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल सिंपलीफाइड केमिस्ट्री। हाउ आर यू ऑल डूइंग? गुड। हाउ इज योर हेल्थ? एवरीथिंग ओके? ओके माय डियर स्टूडेंट, सो इन अ प्रीवियस सेशन वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट एलिवेशन इन बॉइलिंग पॉइंट। सो इन दिस पर्टिकुलर सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस आवर डिप्रेशन इन फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट। क्लियर? दिस इज द इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट ऑल्सो। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट अवर डिप्रेशन इन फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट। This is also part of colligative property, depression in freezing point. I am writing in a short form FP. Depression means it is also known as a decrease. It is also known as what? Decrease in freezing point. Always keep this in your mind. Clear? This is decrease in freezing point. Now, my dear student, what is this? I will explain you with the example. This is a very, very simple theory, as you know that. Clear? So we have taken one beaker and in that I have filled water into it. So you know that, my dear student, water has freezing point what? 0 degree Celsius. So 0 degree Celsius is a freezing point of water. Now whatever the amount of water I will take, whether I will take 10 ml, 20 ml, 100 ml, anything, its freezing point will remain same. 0 degree Celsius, it will never change. Is it clear? Okay, so now when I will dissolve NaCl into it, so we have observed that when we have dissolved NaCl into it, so now this solution's freezing point will be less than 0 degree Celsius. Okay, what I am saying, that solution's freezing point will be less than 0 degree Celsius. Clear? Okay, it will decrease. It means, suppose water will convert into the ice at 0 degree Celsius, after dissolving some amount of NaCl into the water, suppose you have to convert the whole solution into the solid form, so we require less than 0 degree Celsius temperature. Okay, so now question arises, how much it will decrease? It will totally and totally depend on the amount of NaCl. It means it will totally and totally depend on number of solutes. It will totally depend on number of solutes, and that's why this decrease in freezing point is considered as what? Colligative property, my dear student. Clear? Again, I am explaining you how much it will decrease. It will totally depend on NaCl. Let's take two example. We have taken two beaker. We have filled same amount of water into it. Clear? Now here I am adding 1 spoon of NaCl and here I am adding 2 spoon of NaCl. So which one will have the higher freezing point? So this one will have the higher freezing point and here freezing point will be less. Because as you will add 2 spoons of NaCl, it will take much time to convert into the solid. It means it will go into the minus sign. Clear? It will also go into the minus, but it will be more compared to this. Clear? Okay, so understood? Clear? So this is a simple thing about depression in freezing point. So it means depression in freezing point is a colligative property because it depends on the number of solutes. Now, my dear student, here we have to understand one important definition, and that is of freezing point. And then on the base of that, we have to develop the graph. Okay, so what is the definition of freezing point? The freezing point's definition is very, very important and quite confusing. Okay, quite confusion will be there. So now I will clear all the confusion. The temperature, always remember, the temperature at which the vapor pressure of liquid will be equal to vapor pressure of solid state. Vapor pressure of solid state, and this is considered as a freezing point. You are familiar with the simple definition that at the temperature at which the liquid will convert into the solid, it is considered as what? It is considered as what? Freezing point. But this is the new definition. Okay, so you can say that temperature at which the vapor pressure of liquid state will be equal to the vapor pressure of solid state. Now question arise, sir, you are telling us that vapor pressure of solid state, how is it possible? Solid will convert into vapor. So due to that, certain pressure will be there. No, my dear student, this solid vapor pressure we are considering that when we are doing sublimation. Keep this in your mind. When we are doing sublimation, it means when solid will directly convert into the gas, at that time whatever the pressure will be there. It means we have to assume here the sublimation. It means suppose let's give me the example here that we have taken certain solid, and if you are doing the sublimation, the solid will also convert into the vapor, and that pressure is considered as what? Vapor pressure of solid state. Is it clear? Okay, so there must be no confusion now onwards. Is it clear? So you understood what is the vapor pressure of solid state. Now this is a vapor pressure of solid state, and now suppose we have taken liquids. So now it will also convert into a vapor. So whatever the pressure will be there, this vapor pressure will be of liquid. When this vapor pressure will become equal, at that time, at that particular point, this liquid will convert into the solid. So this is the phenomena. Okay, my dear student, please take the screenshot of this. Okay, taken. So now we will discuss the graph, my dear student, because graph is very, very important, and you have to understand why you are obtaining this type of graph. So here also we have to plot the graph of temperature. Okay, so here I am taking what? Temperature. And here I am taking what? Vapor pressure. I am taking what on y-axis? Vapor pressure. X-axis, temperature. So first of all, when we are talking about the solvent, so you know that solvent will have the higher vapor pressure compared to solution. We have already discussed this. So let us assume that this is our solvent's vapor pressure. So I am writing that this is our solvent, pure solvent. Pure solvent's vapor pressure is like this. And you know that it is vapor pressure is directly proportional to temperature. We already discussed this in a previous session. If you are new to my channel, then please go through the previous lecture. You will be able to understand this. Okay. So this is the vapor pressure of pure solvent, because as the temperature will increase, vapor pressure will increase. Now, what will be the vapor pressure of liquid, sorry, solution? So solution's vapor pressure will also increase by increasing the temperature, but solution's vapor pressure will be less than the solvent. So we can plot the graph like this. Clear? Sorry. Again, I am plotting the graph. Okay. This is not proper. Again, I am clear. So this is the graph of what? Pure solvent. I will write here that this is the graph of solvent. And now this is the graph of what? Solution. Okay, so you can see here, as the temperature increases, vapor pressure also increases. Clear? It is very clear. Now, what is the definition of freezing point? So this freezing point means what? The vapor pressure of liquid will be equal to vapor pressure of solid state. At that time, liquid will convert into the solid. So now solids will have also certain vapor pressure. So of course it is. Solid's vapor pressure will be very, very less than the liquid's vapor pressure. So can I plot the graph like this for the solid's vapor pressure? It means solid's vapor pressure will be like this. I am writing here solid. Clear? So this point here also, by increasing the temperature, you can simply, by increasing the temperature, vapor pressure will increase in this case also. But solid's vapor pressure is like this. That means in vapor pressure in solid phase. Solid's vapor pressure means what? Vapor pressure in solid phase. Is it clear? So now, my dear student, you can relate this, that at particular this point, you can say that the vapor pressure of pure solvent will be equal to the vapor pressure in the solid phase. Will be equal to the vapor pressure in the solid phase. So you can say that if you drag this point here, so this will be the, you can say that TF naught. So TF naught means what? Freezing point of pure solvent. Freezing point of pure solvent, because what? When vapor pressure of solid state and liquid state will become equal, same. So at this point it is becoming same. Is it clear? So this is what? Freezing point of pure solvent. Now if I will extend this solution on this side, clear? So I will get that at this particular point, that solution's vapor pressure will be equal to the vapor pressure in the solid phase. So this point, if I will drag, so at this particular temperature, this solution will convert into the solid. So this is considered as a TF, my dear student. So TF means what? You can simply say that freezing point of solution. TF is what? Freezing point of solution. So this difference is considered as Okay, is it clear now? Is it clear? Have you understood the graph? So I am removing this point. Okay, so now you can say that this difference is known as what? Delta TF is equal to TF naught minus TF, because TF naught is more, TF is less. So here also you can say that that solvent has higher freezing point compared to solution. Solution has lower freezing point. Clear? Okay, compared to solvent. So now TF naught, again I am writing freezing point of solvent, and TF is considered as what? Freezing point of solution. And delta TF is considered as what? Depression in freezing point. Or simply you can say that change in freezing point. Or another name is what? Depression in freezing point. Or you can also say that decrease in freezing point. Clear? Okay? Understood? So this is our delta TF value. Understood? Please take the screenshot. Hope the graph will be much clearer and you understood the proper concept including this point. Is it clear? Okay, if you understood, please like the video. Like the video if you understood this. Clear? Then take the screenshot. Okay, so now graph and definition is clear. So what we got here on the base of this? So on the base of this, you can simply say that. Now please pay attention here. This is also a similar part like elevation in boiling point, that what we have done in elevation in boiling point, similar part like that. So now we got that delta TF is equal to TF naught minus TF. It means you can simply say that freezing point of solvent minus freezing point of solution. Experimentally, we found that delta TF is directly proportional to M. The M means what? Molality. So delta TF is directly proportional to the moles of non-volatile solute upon mass of solvent in kg. Mass of solvent in kg. Clear? This is the formula for molality. If we have to remove this sign, we have to put constant. So delta TF is equal to KF into M. Here, what is our KF, my dear student? So KF is what? This is known as a molal depression constant. This is known as what? Molal depression constant. And it is also known as a cryoscopic constant. It is also known as what, my dear student? Cryoscopic constant. Is it clear? Delta TF, you know that change in freezing point, and M means what? Molality. Clear? So here also they can ask the question that define KF. Define KF. So how can you define? Clear? So how can you define? That you know that delta TF is equal to KF into M. When this M will be 1 molar. When this M will be 1 molar. So delta TF is equal to KF. So at 1 molar. At 1 molar of any compound. That compound may be glucose. That compound may be urea, that compound may be sucrose. Clear? Okay, non-volatile solute we are discussing. Okay, so any 1 mole of non-volatile solute, 1 molar is there. So at that time, change in freezing point will be equal to KF. Will be equal to KF. Clear? So here also we can write here that KF value will only and only depends on solvent. It does not depend on solute. Okay, the KF value does not depend on solute. It only depends on solvent. And in 99% case, it is fixed. Okay, in 99% case, KF value is fixed. You have to remember now two things. KF value will be 1.86 for water. For water, almost it is fixed. Now, we have to write this formula in the form of elaborated form of molality. So you can simply say that delta TF is equal to KF into 1000 into W2 upon M2 and W1. Again, I will repeat, 2 stands for solute and 1 stands for solvent here. Clear? So here W2 mass of solute, W1 mass of solvent, M2 molecular mass of solute, Kf molar depression constant, cryoscopic constant, delta Tf change in freezing point. Clear? So by this we have to find out the numericals answer. Clear? Now if I make the subject Kf, so Kf will be what? Molecular mass into delta Tf into W1 upon 1000 into W2. Clear? Okay, so here what will be the unit? This is gram per mole. This is gram, gram cancel out. Okay, so you can simply say that and 1000. So 1000 and it means kg. Gram upon 1000 will be kg. So Kelvin, kilogram, mole inverse. Okay, what will be the unit here? Kelvin, kilogram, mole inverse. So you can simply say that unit of Kf will be Kelvin kilogram mole inverse. This is also important one. So that you have to remember. Now please take the screenshot. I will write another formula for Kf. Okay, clear. So now I am writing here few formulas of Kf that we have already discussed in KB's form also. Clear? So you can simply write here that Kf is equal to R into M1 into Tf square upon 1000 into delta H. But here delta H will be what? Fusion. Here delta H will be the fusion. What is this fusion enthalpy? The fusion enthalpy means what? The energy required to convert one mole of liquid into solid. It is considered as what? Enthalpy of fusion. Okay, and you can write it in the form of what? LF. This is what? Latent heat. You are familiar with that. Clear? Okay, so it will be what? Delta H into M. So you can write this in this form that Kf is equal to R into M1. Sorry, M1 will be cancelled out. R Tf square 1000 into LF. Latent heat of fusion. Clear? Okay. Understood. So like this, these two formulas are also important for the numericals. So please take the screenshot. Okay, how this we can derive, we do not have to go inside that. Clear? But please take the screenshot, my dear students. Then we'll go for the numericals. Okay, so this was the idea. Now in this, we'll discuss so many numericals and few important numericals we'll also discuss. So now please watch the numericals clearly and properly, okay, because these are important. So now let us start with the first numerical that I am only saying the value. You please write it down in your note and pen, okay, on your note with the pen. First one is what? When we dissolve 20 gram of urea, in 500 gram of water. 500 gram of water. Understood what? That when we dissolve 20 gram of urea in 500 gram of water. Okay. So what will be? What will be the freezing point of solution? What will be the freezing point of the solution? Kf is given 1.86 Kelvin kilogram mole inverse. Kf is given to you, that is 1.86 Kelvin kilogram mole inverse. So now what you have to find out? So my dear student, you have to find out freezing point of solution, that it is symbolized by Tf. So before finding the Tf, you must have to find out delta Tf. So what is our formula for delta Tf? So delta Tf is equal to Kf into 1000 into W2 upon M2 into W1. Okay, so I'll make the subject delta Tf. So Kf value is given for water 1.86, okay, into 1000 into W2 mass of solute. So 20 gram urea, so it will be 20. What will be the M2 molecular mass of solute? So my dear student, urea means what? NH2, CO, NH2 is considered as what? Urea. And this has the molecular mass 60. Okay, so this will be the 60 gram per mole, and W1 is also given in gram only 500. So if you will solve this, you will get the delta TF in the unit Kelvin. I am not doing the calculation because calculation is not important. The concept is important. So that's why you have to understand the concept. You can do the calculation, okay, and you can comment it into the comment box. Is it clear? Okay, you can give me the answer there. Now this is, my dear student, only delta TF. But this is delta TF. So delta TF is what? Change in freezing point. This is not our freezing point of solution. So now you can simply say that delta TF is equal to, what was our formula? TF naught minus TF. So delta TF is a blank Kelvin TF naught. So TF naught is what? Pure solvent's freezing point. So solvent is water. So water's freezing point is what? 0 degree Celsius. So 0 degree Celsius means 273 Kelvin minus TF. Clear? 273 Kelvin. Understood how it came? Because of water. If instead of water any other solvent is given to you, so at that time the freezing point of that particular solvent will be given to you. Clear? In the numerator here you have to write the delta TF, whatever the answer you are getting. And on the base of that also you can find out TF into the Kelvin, as well as, and after that you can convert it into the degree Celsius also. Is it clear, my dear student? Please take the screenshot of this, then we'll go for the another numerical. Okay? Understood? Okay, so now let us start the another one, and this is also quite confusing. Students are having so much confusion in this. So let me ask you this question. When 50 gram of glucose and 20 gram of urea are mixed in 500 gram of water, 500 gram of water, KF is 1.86 Kelvin kilogram mole inverse. Okay, so what will be the depression in freezing point? Or else they can also write, ask that what will be the freezing point of solution. But here, if you will see 50 gram of glucose and 20 gram of urea, two different compounds we are dissolving up to now. Up to now what it was? Up to now only one compound was there, and that was only urea. So now in this case we are dissolving urea as well as glucose. So my dear student, your concept is most important. This formula you can solve it like this, that delta TF is equal to KF into molality. Okay, so KF into, you can simply write here that moles of solute upon mass of solvent in kg. Mass of solvent in kg. So my dear student, this delta TF, I am writing here, delta TF is which property? Colligative property. Keep this in your mind. Delta TF is what? Colligative property. So whenever colligative property comes, it should strike in your mind that colligative properties depend on number of solute, but does not depend on the nature of solute. Whatever we have filled inside it, it does not depend on the nature of glucose and urea. We only have to consider the number of solute particles, that is 50 gram. It means, can I find out the moles of both of them? That glucose mole will be what? That 50 upon 180, and urea's mole will be what? 60 upon 20. So in this formula I have to substitute the moles of solute like this. Please keep attention here. So now, okay, delta TF is equal to KF is what? 1.86. Now moles of solute, it means it will be 50 upon 180 plus 60 upon 20 upon mass of solvent in kg. This is 500 gram. We have to convert it into the kg. It means 0.5 kg. This will be our answer. This plus sign here. Do not forget. Okay, and this Kelvin will be our answer. Is it clear, my dear students? So this is very, very important question. Students are making so many mistakes in this. But if your concepts are clear, it will be very, very easier for you. Is it clear, my dear student? Please take the screenshot. Okay, please take the screenshot. Okay, so now, after this, we are going to discuss the last numerical, last type of numericals. I told you that I will also include the certain numericals together. It means this type of numerical can also come for molar elevation constant. Same thing you have to do. Now you understood? Okay. So here the last numerical is there, that 5% glucose solution, aqueous solution. 5% glucose aqueous solution has freezing point 271 Kelvin. Has freezing point 271 Kelvin. So 5% sucrose solution will have how much freezing point of solution? It means, my dear student, which things are given to you, that 5% glucose aqueous solution has freezing point 271. 5% sucrose aqueous solution will have how much freezing point? Clear? So it means now this numerical can be done by two methods. So I will show you the first method. Okay, first method. The first method is what? That we have to find out the freezing point of the solution. Here 5% glucose, so you can say that 95% water is there, aqueous solution. Here also water is there. So it means water, our solvent. Solvent is water, TF naught is 273 Kelvin. We have that. Water has freezing point 273 Kelvin. So for this, delta TF is equal to KF into 1000 into W2 upon M2 into W1. Now, for this, KF value is not given for sucrose. So I am writing here KF, 1000 is 1000. W2, the 5% sucrose, what does it mean? We already studied in earlier lectures. Clear? The 5 gram is dissolving into 95 gram. So weight of solute 5 gram, sucrose 342 because C12H2211. And W1 will be 95. Clear? Okay, but KF is not given. So how can you find out the KF? If you put the value of KF, then only you will get what? Delta TF. So KF I am finding here, that to find out the KF, we have to use the first thing, glucose. Because you know that in that also water is there. So I told you that for water, the solvent KF value will remain. If solvent is same, the KF value will also remain same. So delta TF is equal to KF into 1000 into W2 upon M2 into W1. Okay, so now I have to make the subject KF. So KF is equal to what? Delta TF into M2 into W1 upon 1000 into W2. Now delta TF is what? Change in freezing point. So freezing point of solution is given 271 and freezing point of water is given 273. So change in freezing point is 2, so delta TF will be 2. Molecular mass of glucose, it will be 180. W1, 95, 1000, and into W2 will be 5. Here also 5% is given, so 5. So like this, you will get the TF, Kelvin, kilogram, mole inverse, and you have to substitute that TF value here, so you will get delta TF in Kelvin. And then delta TF is equal to TF naught minus TF. So on the base of this, delta TF value here, TF naught 273 minus TF. So you will get the TF in the Kelvin. Is it clear? So this is the first method and the long method. Okay, understood how to do this? Clear? I am giving you short method. Please take the screenshot first. Okay, so now I will give you the short method. In this short technique, you will be able to do this. So what you have to do? So you have to do the ratio of this delta TF1. We are considering glucose as 1 and sucrose as 2 upon delta TF2 is equal to what? KF1 into M1 upon here also KF2 into M2. So KF will remain same because solvent is same. So just we have to do what? Delta TF1 upon delta TF2 is equal to molality. It means you have to write what? Mole per kg. Here also you have to write mole per kg. So directly you will get delta TF2. So by this method also you will be able to understand the delta TF2 directly, and then you can go for the TF. Is it clear? I just took the ratio. So whatever the method, now this is our second method. Whatever the method is convenient to you, you have to solve this type of numericals with that. Is it clear, my dear student? Understood? Please take the screenshot of this. Okay, so in this particular lecture, we have discussed the depression and freezing point. The main important thing was the graph. Then the formulas and everything were similar to the elevation and boiling point. Is it clear? Understood? And numericals, we discussed that new numericals also. So it will be very, very helpful to you. Now, my dear student, please use reference books, textbook, everything, and solve this type of numerical. If you have any doubt, please comment in the comment box. Is it clear? And if you have liked my video, as usual, my dear student, please keep commenting. Please like the video, share the video with your friends and other students also. Clear? Thank you so much for your love, care and concern. And you are showing so much love to my channel as well as to the videos of mine. Thank you so much. I'm really grateful to you. Thank you so much, my dear students. Thank you so much.